Hi, this is Lydia Nexus. Welcome to my tutorial on how to get your first isolation party started and how to set up a live DJ stream for YouTube. Let's first put on some lights. LEDs everywhere. Let's put on some more LEDs, LED strips. Turn on your controller. Turn on your speakers. One. Another one. Turn on extra decorations and more lights. Pineapples. More pineapples. Just make it look really pretty and the way you want to. Set up a laptop. Here's my MacBook. Then connect the master out of your controller with an audio interface. I'm using two DSLR cables here and I'm connecting it to a Tascam US16x8. Start the OBS studio program after downloading and installing, obviously. There you go. And it should recognize the webcam or the camera of your computer. You can check which device it is recognizing, and here it's just the built-in sight. I didn't connect any other camera. I'm just gonna use this. And then you can also go to settings. It's still in German. Well, you can change the language at the top. Change it from German to English. And there you have all your settings. For example, your audio settings. And you can go to your stream settings. And here you have to paste your YouTube stream key, which you will find when you've created a streaming event on YouTube in the live control room. So let's start some music. Open your channel. As we can see, the audio signal is picked up by OBS Studio. Still in the green. We can increase the volume a little bit. Now it's already yellow. Try not to hit the red. Start the recording and start the stream. That's basically it. Now, version 2, adding a nice camera. So if you have a digital camera and you'd like to use that video signal for your stream, you need a capture card. So I got the AverMedia Portable 2 Plus, which is compatible with my very old MacBook, luckily. It has a separate HDMI output, so you can even attach a big screen, such as a TV or computer screen. Then the other cable has a USB connection that fits into your laptop, and wait till it stops flashing and it's good to go. And of course you still need to connect to the HDMI port of your camera, which is usually micro HDMI, so be sure to get the right cables. Here you see which system I'm running. I'm just running High Sierra version 10.13.6, which is just okay to be running the utility for AverMedia, which you can download on their homepage. Download it and run it. It looks like this. There you get some extra options for settings. So then start up your camera. Now the fun part, you add a new video capture device in OBS Studio. I'm naming it Camera In. Okay. And there you get the option of choosing your capture card. And there you go. You get the signal from your camera and it shows up in OBS Studio. Wonderful. And that's basically it. A few more tips. Something else you will need to keep your camera running continuously is this dummy battery. And that will continuously supply your camera with power. Another nice thing to have is some helping lights. So I got this light. You can add different filters for warm filter or blue filter, and it will improve the picture quality of your video recording. So to make it a bit more exciting, I also added a beamer with a separate laptop where I had a collection of trippy visuals running. I collected them first, then I combined them into one long file so I could leave it running without any interruptions. Well, then you can start a stream. Be sure to copy the right YouTube stream link into OBS Studio. If you've created a scheduled event, it will have a separate key which needs to be put into OBS, so OBS streams into the scheduled event. Now you're good to go. Start mixing, start partying, have other people join you live, enjoy the chat with the people while you're mixing. That was my short tutorial on how to set up a live DJ stream. I hope you succeed in setting up your own live events. Let me know what you think, whether it worked out or whether you still have questions in the comments. And it would mean the world to me if you also subscribe to my channel. Hope to see you soon. Bye.